हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जैसे कि हम डिस्कस कर रहे हैं सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स, इससे पीछे वाली वीडियो में मैंने डिस्कस किया था जनरल डेफिनेशंस और द टर्म्स रिलेटेड विद दैट ऑफ द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। तो उसी को कंटिन्यू करते हुए कुछ और टर्म्स, कुछ और डेफिनेशंस मैं आज डिस्कस करूंगी। फर्स्ट इज द गैमेटोजेनेसिस। दिस इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट्स और द गैमेट्स। जैसे आपको पता ही है, इन हायर ऑर्गेनिज्म टू टाइप्स ऑफ गैमेट्स विल बी फॉर्म। वन इज इन द मेल, सेकंड इज इन द फीमेल। मेल गैमेट फॉर्मेशन इज नोन एज स्पर्मोजेनेसिस एंड फीमेल गैमेट फॉर्मेशन इज नोन एज ओजेनेसिस। And in the case of plants that I am talking about, the angiosperms or the high class of plants, firstly is the formation of pollen grains. The process of formation of pollen grain is known as microsporogenesis. And in the pollen grains, there is the formation of male gamete. And this process is known as microgametogenesis. Similarly, in the case of female part, that is the formation of ovule, that is known as megasporogenesis. And in the ovule, there is the formation of the female gamete, this process is known as megagametogenesis. As we know that, what are pollen grains? Pollen grains, they are the male gamete forming organ. In this case, pollen grains, they are a yellow color powdery structure which can move from, which can flow with the wind, with air, from one place to another. The after the formation of the gametes, as in the case of higher organism or in the case of plants, next step is the transfer of gamete. How these gametes, they are transferred from that of the male organ to that of the female sex organ? So in the case of plants, the mechanism is different. For example, if we talk about that of the lower plants like bryophytes, the male gamete, that is motile, that means it's free, it will move with water or it will swim to that, move to the female gamete, and the female gamete is non-motile. But in the case of blue-green algae, both the gametes, if formed, they are motile. But in the case of higher organisms, in the, that is, we are talking about angiosperms, because we are talking about the flower-producing plants. In the case of angiosperms, the pollens, they are transferred from that of the anthers, that is the male organ, to that of the stigma, which is the part of the pistil or the female sex organ. So how these pollens, they are transferred from that of the male sex organ to that of the female sex organ, that is different in that case of animals and in the case of plants. In the case of animals, there is a specific transfer mechanism. So there is a special way of transfer of that of the male gamete to that of the female gamete. That particular process is known as copulation. As a result of copulation, there is the mixing, or that is the combination of male gamete and the female gamete, takes place and result in the fertilization. So what is fertilization? Fertilization is the fusion of male gamete and female gamete. Now the fertilization is also known as syngamy. It is further of two types, external and internal. As this term suggests, in external fertilization, the male gamete and the female gamete, they fuse outside the body of the male and the female. That may be in water. For example, in the case of frogs, both the male gamete and the female gamete, they are released into the water, and in the water, male gamete and the female gamete fuse to each other, result in the formation of the zygote. So this type of fertilization is known as external fertilization. And in the case of internal fertilization, that is different from external. In this case, the male gamete and the female gamete fuse inside a particular body. For example, in higher organisms like birds, reptiles and mammals, male gamete, it transfer to the female body and fuse inside that of the female sex organ, result in the formation of the zygote. So in this case, the fertilization is internal, and the examples are birds, reptiles and mammals. After the fertilization, there is the formation of zygote. Now how this zygote develop? This zygote undergo the whole process of development and result in the formation of embryo. This process is known as embryogenesis. Now how this zygote develop in both the different cases, that is in external and internal, let us discuss this. In the case of frogs, when the external fertilization takes place, the eggs, they are released, they are in the, that is the fertilized, or the fertilized egg, or we can say that is the zygote, that is in the water, that hatches and result in the formation of the small larva, and that larva then undergo into metamorphosis and result in the formation of the next stage and result in the adult frog. So in that case, all the nutrients that are not sufficient for the zygote to complete develop into the embryo. So firstly, the eggs ruptures and a larva, it results or it come out that of the egg, that process in which the yolk is not sufficient to provide all the nutrient to that of the growing embryo. As a result of this, the larva or the pupa, it come out of that of the egg. So that is a different case. But in the case of, if we talk about reptiles, that is in the case of lizard, all the nutrients, they are present in the eggs that are sufficient and develop the complete embryo. For example, when the egg broke down or it hatches, that result in the formation of a baby bird or a baby lizard or a small baby that has complete its organs, that is complete in itself. That means the eggs, they have sufficient yolk that provide all the nutrients that result in the formation of complete organism. That stage or in which the embryo completely develop from that of the that is the zygote, that process or that egg is known as the doic eggs. in this case yolk is sufficient and it provide all the nutrients and result in the complete formation of the embryo. But in the case of frog, the yolk is very less as a result of this. Firstly, that pupa comes and it undergo different stages and result into the complete formation of the frog. Now the organisms, they are further categorized into two ways. One are the oviparous and the second one is viviparous. Oviparous organisms are the egg laying organisms and viviparous are the which give birth to young ones. They come under viviparous. Now in the case of plants, how the embryo formed and what is the embryo? In the case of plant, embryo is the part which is present inside the seed. Seed may be naked, that is in the case of gymnosperms, or seed may be covered with that of the covered inside that of the fruit, that is the angiosperms, in which the seed is covered inside the fruit. This is the fruit and the seed, inside the seed there is the embryo which can result in the formation of complete new plant. When we sow this seed, the seed contain the embryo, or you can say the egg cell, which can result in the formation of the complete plant. So these are the general terms which I have discussed in these two lectures that will help us to understand the next two chapters, that is the reproduction in a flowering plant and in the human beings. In the next video, I will discuss the structure of flower and the structure of the anther. Students, this is a humble request to all of you. Please like and share this video to the students who actually need this video, and please subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching.